we'll go for it. And hopefully at the end we'll have a little bit of time for questions, but it's a quick 20-minute. Definitely won't get into the depth that I'm passionate about, but we'll get started. So I'm Faith Rothberg, and I'm the CEO of College Recruiter. At College Recruiter, we help employers hire dozens, hundreds, and thousands of students into and grads into internships and entry-level jobs. And we've been doing it for quite some time and have a lot of great relationships with some of the employers that are here year over year, so it's great to see people. Today, I'm going to talk about why you should hire more women, not only into your company, but into your leadership, and continue to develop and promote women for a lot of great reasons. And by the end, I'm going to share some amazing success stories from some of the large employers, and I'll also be able to give you some suggestions for getting started. So first, so you understand my background and where I'm coming from, I went to the University of Wisconsin in Madison for my undergrad, and I did study besides party, I promise. And out of there, I was really fortunate to get a great computer programming job out of the business school. I went to work for Ford Motor Company in a place where I didn't know anybody, just a new job, and it was really awesome. From there, I knew that I didn't want to stay in Detroit forever. It was a great place to get started, but I wanted to get back where my family's from, which is Minneapolis, Minnesota. And so I went through the career service office, and they had great companies coming on campus, and I could look for one in Minneapolis, and I ended up getting a job out of the Michigan MBA program with KPMG in IT consulting. From there, after spending 3 years at KPMG, they had told me it was 30% travel, and for me and some of our colleagues, we decided that they meant over a 10-year period because I traveled 100% of the time. I lived with two other women on a big project in Toronto for a year, going back and forth. And those women, I was a young adult in my mid-20s. Those women, one was 38 and divorced, and one was 32 and still doing this. And I was like, this is not what I want in my life. So I went back to Michigan and said, to the career service office, and said, can you give me a list of your alumni that live in Minneapolis? Because I didn't have LinkedIn, and I didn't have the internet at that time. So I found a lot of great management. Graduated 20 years before me, and I just reached out and said, hey, can I talk to you about your career path and how you got where you were? I'm a Michigan alum. And ended up landing a great job through that process at what was then Norwest Bank, now Wells Fargo, where I managed a lot of computer programmers and went on to manage kind of the big bad distributed system that were coming around. And I would turn around those projects. And then we started to have a family. College Recruiter has been around. My husband and business partner is Stephen Rothberg, and he was the founder. And he's the entrepreneur. He's the visionary guy. And I'm the woman behind the man. I'm the, you know, the one that can manage all the people and make the process really happen. And so we decided with the little kids that I wasn't, in my career, I wasn't being a great mom and I wasn't being a great professional anymore, and I decided to start staying home with our little kids. And from there, I was like the free consultant to my husband for a while he ran the business. And then about 6 years ago, as our kids got a lot older and were much more independent and self-sufficient, I jumped in and we started running the business together. So that's my background. So even though I've only been full-time in the business for the last 6 years, I still have that knowledge of all those years. And one of the things that we really like is that we learn from you guys every day, and we continue to try to do things that really help you. So why is this important? Why is it important to talk about gender equity in companies? Really, half the population are women. Is it not? Are you okay? Okay. Can you guys all hear okay? Yeah? Okay. You're up front, so I'm glad, but I was wondering. So half our population is women. Now, I could not believe this when I saw this. There are more Johns and Davids running large companies than there are all the women in the U.S. Something's wrong with that picture, right? So that's part of why. The real reason, though, is that there are really great positive impacts on your work environment. And you know, here's a list of them. We'll talk about some of them as we go. Two of the key things that I think are really important is they change and enhance your employee culture, the culture at your company. Your employees are more engaged. They tend to be more more productive, and they engage with your customers on a more even playing field because there's that diversity. The second piece is that it's good for your bottom line. That's the bottom line. It is good for your profits. So here's the reason why it's good for your profits. There's studies that 13 times the average sales revenue when you have gender diversity. And they also show that these companies had 15,000 more customers, ones that were much more diverse and had women in management. We still have a long way to go, and many companies definitely are behind on this, but this basically shows all these different management positions and how many women to how many men are in it. But the main thing to point out is that that in executive roles there's less than 35% of that. And in IT, which I know some of you are pretty darn concerned about and is my sort of personal passion, there's only 27% women. So we really have a long way to go. So one of the things that I wanted to do really was highlight how some of these companies that have really put their heart and their culture and their vision into driving gender equity, how they've done it. So I decided to use this list of companies as an example. And some of them are here today, and I encourage you guys all, people who aren't doing it, to look to these companies, try to find these talent acquisition professionals, because they've done a lot of hard work, and they really know and understand what some of the issues were, what were the hurdles, how are you going to overcome those hurdles, how to put some of these programs in place that you'll see as examples. One of the things I forgot to say at the beginning is that on my front slide and on the last slide, there's a place where you can download this presentation. And I highly recommend doing that. And I should have said in the beginning, in case you didn't feel like you needed to take notes. But one of the reasons that I think that is that I did that is because, as you'll see these examples from different companies, I've just put some quick information, but there's links to some of the articles that were the impetus for me, at least understanding and knowing what they've done. Some more in the past, but have continued to do new and bigger things that I maybe didn't find right now, but these were like real catalysts for when they started doing it, and some more current. So let's start with Aramark. Aramark, if you don't know, is a really large food service company. They're in a lot of the hotels are a really good company, do a lot of good work and employ a lot of people. One of the things that they did was they went ahead and instead of just advocating for it, they really developed a plan to get more women into leadership roles. And they did that with this Women in Food Service Forum, which was a professional organization that was trying to encourage women leaders. And so what Aramark did was, instead of just being part of that group, that association, they decided to be one of the key catalysts And they went ahead to become a catalyst with just them and Coca-Cola Company. So really, really put their money and their efforts where their mouth was about gender diversity. And through that program, they were able to build and develop the younger women in the company into leadership roles. So that's one example. And and they're definitely here, so try and find them if you'd like to talk to them about what they did. There's Stephanie. Hi, Stephanie. Awesome job. Bank of America is another one. Bank of America, what they did was they had this LEAD program, which was a development program for women. And it really was to promote the professional development of women. And they did things like mentoring. They had informal groups where women would meet to talk about the different levels they were at. And they just really encouraged it throughout their culture. And by doing that, they've gotten to the point where about half managers and executives are women. And, you know, as you can see from some of those previous slides, that's huge. That's not where most large organizations are right now. So that's B of A, and people are here from there as well. Shout out, there you go. Good to see you. Thanks for coming. A third example is Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Enterprise Rent-A-Car, we've known the guys at Enterprise Rent-A-Car for a long time. We've worked with them for many years, and I'm always just so impressed and astounded by what they can accomplish in the college recruiting space. So for those of you who don't know, Enterprise Rent-A-Car is a privately held company that really believes in hiring entry-level folks and really training them about the whole business and then having them get promoted to the top ranks. And the way that I say there's no better way to show that you are dedicated to gender equity than to say that the family-owned and run business, when they hired their first CEO in 2013, I believe, that was not a family member, is a woman, Pam Nicholson. That's putting your message really to work and putting your money where your mouth is. So, and they just continue to do great things with gender equity. And in fact, their chairman now, who's not the CEO, he wants to keep the private business in the family. And the next one of the next family members is a young woman who's now heading up, I think, their operations, or right? COO, yeah. So that's his daughter. So grooming the next woman into leadership. So, and definitely talk to those folks. They do a great job. Another company that's had a great story is Ernst & Young. So are those guys here? I know Dan and people. No, not right now. Well, Ernst & Young is another one of our customers we've worked with for a long time, and I really admire what they're doing. They constantly are branding and looking for professionals into their auditing, their accounting, and their finance fields. They're constantly looking for diverse candidates. Diverse in race, gender, all of it, but really focused on also getting women into leadership roles. And they've done that through a lot of accountability of their current senior management, which, you know, over time will turn into more women, but were mostly men who then needed to make sure that they were grooming and helping women in their area get promoted and grow as leaders. So they're up to 20% of their senior leaders. And that's another one to talk to. This one's a little dear to my heart because Goldman Sachs has a program called the Goldman Sachs 10,000 Women Program. It's done through their foundation. And one of the things that I think is really cool is what they did was their foundation is to create economic growth. And they wanted to do it around the world. So what they were doing was training women to start and grow small businesses in their communities by training them through a leadership program, a business program that they do in concert with the Babson, with Babson College. And Babson College has the number one entrepreneurship program in the country. It's partly near and dear to my heart because one of the things is they also have a 10,000 small businesses program, and I was fortunate enough to be one of the scholars in that program last year. And they basically teach you how to build that growth plan for your company. So super excited about the networking and the learning I did there. And they worked specifically in the Middle East and Africa with the Department of State. So the U.S. Department of State is very committed as well to gender equity, and they put together a program with Goldman Sachs specifically for the Middle East and Africa to bring women from those places to the U.S. for a 2 to 3 week training program to hope and get them to go back and encourage other women. And I think they have follow-ups to that as well. So definite shout out to the Department of State. I think it's awesome. Is anybody here from there? I think I talked to one person. Oh, there you go. Thank you so much. I think the stuff you're doing is awesome. Another player quite early in the gender equity development was IBM. Some of the information that I saw went back to the late 80s, early 90s, where they put together a task force of different groups, different diverse groups, one of which was women. They did really extensive different groups. They had an LGBTQ group back then, which was really on the cutting edge, I think, back then, and they had some other different groups. And what they did was they put together, it was almost like focus groups and steering committees where they really tried to understand, you know, one of the things with diversity and really making it work, because a lot of people will say, oh, it doesn't work, you know, people get mad, they don't talk to each other, they take, you have unconscious bias. Have you guys heard that expression, unconscious bias? You know, so you don't realize that it's easier to accept what someone who thinks like you is saying because it fits your brain scheme. And the real big difference in that is if you're going to really make diversity and work, then you have the inclusion piece, and the inclusion piece is really taking and getting people to understand that they have this unconscious bias. Don't pretend you don't. We all do. We all come from different backgrounds, different experiences. But then realize that and take a minute to stop and really listen to whatever that diverse person from you is talking about. And you end up being so much more innovative. You get different perspectives. And so that's what IBM found. And they found that they increased their actual sales to small business minorities, small and medium-sized business minority owners and women-owned businesses. They increased their sales from $10 million to $300 million. It's crazy, but it's proof, you know, that it really works. So anybody here from IBM? Awesome. Thank you so much. It's very cool. So remember where people are waving, because go grab them, sorry. No, I don't, go hide. Right? So another company that's doing amazing things, and first name again, John. You're one of those Johns. I'm just teasing, but it's one of those Johns that is working very closely with one of those suits. The Quicken Loans, which is located in the heart of Detroit. And guess what? You know why I know that? Because I'm a customer of Quicken Loans. And if anybody's ever called Quicken Loans customer service, the way they answer is, hi, welcome to Quicken Loans. We're the proud company located in downtown Detroit. All excited, which is awesome. And you know, when you saw where I came from, one of my first jobs was at Ford. And so I was in Detroit. So I know what Detroit was like, and I used to go downtown. There was one little spot I could go, and the redevelopment of Detroit, and partly thanks to Quicken Loans, is so much better. It's really bringing like even farmers markets and art, all this kind of stuff to downtown Detroit. It's really great. Anyway, one of the things that they've been rated as like the top place for women in tech to work. And part of that is because they have 45% of employees are women. And look at that number, 43% of management are women. That's incredible. So anybody who can get it up that high, right? And it's proof in how it works, because Quicken Loans is rocking. I mean, it's doing very, very well. It's very successful. And so, so shout out to Quicken Loans. Keep doing what you're doing. Hiring. The other thing I saw was, because of tech, it was really interesting to find out how many women in tech are in Detroit. And it makes sense when I thought about it. Clearly, I was there long ago, but there's so much automation and technology in the automotive industry, into all the ancillary industries that come into the automotive business, that it didn't surprise me once I really started thinking about it. So very cool. And so out of all this, I guess the biggest thing is, I was really excited about what Mace said the theme was this year, because it says be inspired. So one of the reasons I wanted to talk about this is hope to try to inspire you guys, because I'm so passionate about it. And when you're passionate about something, I think it just comes through and it can be infectious. And so why not talk about what matters a lot to you? And I often joke, on one side is my husband, Stephen Rothberg, who has incredible knowledge around what you guys do every day, and has watched you do it every day, and has learned from you, and that sort of stuff. And then there's me on this side, and I love what you guys do too, but I say if we have to yin and yang, I'm the candidate side, because I just love trying to encourage young people to get into things. And so, like, be inspired. One of the things for me was I judge FIRST Robotics tournaments. And I do that because I'm a woman in STEM, and I really want those high school girls to start realizing that there are great paths in STEM for girls. And if they continue, and they're obviously passionate if they're already doing it in high school. That's my inspired story. When I saw that word, I had to say that. Really, in wrapping up, there's just that it's... these are some of the key components. You know, we talked about diversity and inclusion and how far that can take you. And it helps with your products, your service, your customer engagement, your revenues, and your bottom line, your profits. So if you guys have questions, feel free. There's some great authorities on it around us, and I hope all of you guys get to promote and encourage gender diversity. And for all of the women genders, I hope that you're seeing that in your companies for yourselves as well. Thanks a lot.